One more time. And shoulders, one by one. With arms. Starting movement in your shoulders, in your scapula. Not just in arms, very engaged, muscle engaged movement. Nice, just three circles. Now fix your fingers and actual wrist circles. Very nice. And palms. Drumming flames. Make sure that your pinky finger is also engaged in this movement. All fingers, all hand. From one side, very nice hand undulation. One more time. Make sure you support your elbow, you don't drop it. Support it. Very nice, from elbows. Reverse. Nice, from shoulders. And reverse. Chest up. Up, 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 up. Now it's warm up still, so don't worry that much. It's just chest, it's just shoulders. You're just warming up, very relaxed. Hips, figure eight. With arms. Bigger arm movements. Hopefully also bigger hip movements. Again, very relaxed, chill. This is warm up, don't worry. Does it look belly dance-ish, doesn't it? From side to side. Relax your neck. Now starting from the hip. As if like super exaggerated Maya with your entire body. Also relax your neck. But first push hip. 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 Hip circles. Reverse. One more time, reverse. And. And undulation. Again, just warm-up style. A bit faster. But big, it's a full body undulation, just don't engage your neck. We're not going literally full body, but chest, belly, hips, relaxed legs. Very nice, hips up and down. and twist. Make sure here you're twisting your hips, not your arms. It can be smaller, it doesn't need to be that big movement. But make sure you're not holding your breath and you're actually moving what you're supposed to move, it's your hips. A bit faster. Maintaining the same speed, consistent speed in your hips. Transfer weight on one leg. And switch. Still horizontal twist. Don't transform it into anything else. Twist only in your hips, not in your entire legs. You're not doing twisting, just hips. Try to go a bit faster with your hips. Just hips, not arms. No shaking here. Very calm. Just hips. Now, every time you lean to the side, point your finger, point your toes, point. So lift leg and point, point. While you're still twisting. Make sure that you lift your leg up, it doesn't become into full twisting with legs. No, you're trying to hide the heel from the audience. So the foot doesn't move, but your hips does. Hips do. Keep breathing, I know. Very nice. Plie, up. Plie, up. On plie, keep your heels on the floor and knees parallel. Chest up, down, up, down. You're on relevé, you're on toes. Push it into the floor, feeling how grounded, how stable you are. You can stay like this forever. And chest square. Up, side, down, side. Switch direction. Still on the relevé. Very nice. Relax. Shake. Give a nice gentle stretch to one calf. Make sure that your back is straight. Also make sure that you are keeping your foot even, parallel. You're not twisting. Actually bring your pinky toes up, so you're not letting it go down. Switch the leg and bring it up. Making sure you're not leaving one side hanging down. It's evenly bringing up. Very nice. Hips area or lower belly area. You go in, down. In, release. In, release. So you will feel engagement of your belly muscles. They will go in and engaged. But it's not just belly muscle movement. You're actually using little pivoting in your hip joint, in the hip bones, to bring it in. but not full body. I'm not moving my upper body, just down part, down below my belly button. And make sure you're not going back. We don't have a curve in our back. You just release down. You do feel engagement in belly, but don't transform it into belly muscle movement. You use your bones and joints to help you. Now, the same movement, accented up, 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 up. You will feel engagement in your lower glutes and transform into your hips. It's belly muscle movement, but it's a lot also moving here. It actually initiates from this pivoted motion. Belly muscles, it's like addition, if I want to add here. Very nice, hold up, hold in. Now you do the same movement, but we'll do accent on the release part. So, don't forget, we are not pushing out, we are not curving our back, we just release it, but we are gonna do it accented. So our neutral position is with lower belly in, let's say tucked in, but don't go too much, of course. It's just this natural pivoting motion in your hip bones, use this. So this is our neutral position, we release as an accent. Transferring weight. You should be able to breathe normally. You should be able to talk. And there is no curve in our back at any moment. The movement happens only in the front part of my body. This one, there is another movement, but we are not working on it right now. We are working on this belly accent. Very nice. So this is a great alternative whenever you want to do in your combos a belly accent like out as if you are poking with a needle, like I literally call it belly accent. But instead of going big, if you want to go for isolated movement, this is a great alternative. It's small, but if you isolate it just here, it's very powerful. So we're gonna do it with a step. We're gonna combine two movements. So our belly accent out will be literally, we'll start with it. So we are standing on one leg, whichever you start doesn't matter. You go with belly accent out. So on the release part, it's our accent. While we are transferring our weight on the with a step forward, we're gonna do chest up, down. Place another leg, belly accent. While we're transferring, chest up, down. Belly accent, chest up, down. So give yourself a little bit of space. We'll go forward for like four steps. When we stay in the pose, it's belly. When we transition, while we transition, it's chest up, down. So let's try it. Let's do it slow first. And. Very nice. Once again. And. Now we'll go a little bit faster with our chest, so we do it actually even. One, two, three, four. Transition is chest, pose is belly. back to neutral. Nice, and omis. Omis include all four points here. So they include sides, the regular up and down sides. It includes this belly tucked in. And on omis, we can add a little bit of curve, but I really highly encourage you. There are different techniques of how to do omi, but don't exaggerate, don't go back. This movement, it exists, but I highly encourage you to do omis focused more on the front part. So it's more about tucking in. If you're doing a regular omi, if you're not doing reversed omi. So it's tuck in and release, tuck in, release. And switch the side. And switch the side. And let's walk forward with omi, continuous omi. And back. And forward and back. Every step two omis. Four steps forward, four steps back. Accent. And back with omis. And belly accent. And add in diagonals. Chest is always forward, but belly is on diagonal. Last time. Okay, so we had today a very cool drill that Pedro was adjusting his music very often to whatever we were doing. Now at the end of the drill, we'll actually switch, and now instead of him following us, we will be following him. So it's an open task. He will be playing a bunch of different tremolos, mainly try to keep it in tremolo. And our task is just to work on shimmies. You don't have to follow me. It's an exercise for you to actually listen to the music. Of course, I'll be dancing so you can get some ideas, but it's more about you listening to music and trying to interpret music with your shimmies, whichever you feel like, layers on top of it or whatever you feel, but keep it in the shimmy spectrum, let's say. Unless Patrick unexpectedly will throw us something else. So let's try. Again, it's not about right now, we'll take a few minutes, it's not about technique, it's about listening to the music.